Hey, new guy, right? I'm Hector Flores. Welcome to the PC.
Thanks. I'm excited to get going, especially since I heard you started last week.
Started here, at least. I've been training in wrestling for years before this. It's part of growing up in Mexico.
Are you from one of those famous wrestling families?
No, where I'm from, you were either into wrestling or football. Sorry, soccer. I chose wrestling.
I chose football. American, to be clear. I had no interest in all that running they do in soccer. Plus, I love the physicality of football.
I can see how that relates to wrestling, but how'd you end up here?
Football is a team sport, and I don't play well with others. Just ask any of my former teammates what happened when they pissed me off.
So, athletic guy who can't control his temper wants to find new way to get paid. Is that about right?
Yeah, that pretty much sums it up. That okay with you?
I guess we'll find out.
Hey, who are you?
My first day training here. Who are you?
Seriously? Have you not been watching Japanese wrestling for the past 6 years? I'm Paragon J. Pierce, the biggest free agent WWE's signed since AJ Styles. Bigger, actually.
I haven't had time to watch Japanese wrestling. I was busy playing football at the highest level in the world.
So you're a football player, huh? Man, you guys are all the same. You come into our sport think it's gonna be easy, but you're in for a real wake-up call. I don't plan on being here very long. They actually should have never sent me here to begin with. But I'm gonna take this opportunity to send you running back to whatever team you were cut from.
I'll be the first one to admit, I have a lot to learn. But I'm not going to be intimidated by someone just because they have more experience than I do. You can do or say whatever you want, but I won't give up.
All right. Well, I guess we'll find out about that soon enough. Good luck, rookie.
I heard you were starting today. Big fan.
Thanks. You're a football fan?
No, not really. I just liked your team's colors. Big purple fan. That'll be the color of my gear when I get to WWE. But anyway, I actually have an athletic background too. I spent some time in minor league baseball.
Really? Who'd you play for?
Well, I wasn't a player. I was actually a mascot named Ribby. But I was around a ton of good athletes.
Oh, okay. Well, that counts for something, I guess.
The best part of the job was they used to have indie wrestling shows at the stadium all the time, where I got to rub elbows with legends like Jerry the King Lawler. He found out I was training on the side as a wrestler and actually helped me get a shot here. Not that I couldn't have made it on my own.
So that explains it. You're Lawler's charity case.
It's not like that. I deserve to be here. You'll see.
Sure. If I need a mascot to cheer me on, I'll let you know.
Whatever. I was gonna ask you to autograph your football card for me, but now I'm not sure I want it. Probably not worth anything anyway.
Relax. I was just giving you a hard time. I'll sign your card. You might need to sell it after you get cut here.
Seriously?
I'm messing with you again. See you out there, Case.
Messing with me again, right?
What do you mean?
You called me Case, but my name's Chase. Good one.
Oh yeah, totally messing with you. That's me, full of jokes.
I'd like to officially welcome our newest recruit to the start of his WWE journey. The rest of you've heard this speech already, so we'll try to make it quick.
On our first day, he did the whole ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages thing. It was awesome.
We'll do the talking, Chase.
I was just telling him about your cool DX intro you did.
Chase!
What Road Dogg was getting at is we are going to give you the foundation to succeed in WWE. What you do with it is up to you.
Keep in mind, you will be judged at all times. The big man in the sky is always watching.
Not that big man. There's a camera up there with a live feed that goes directly to Triple H's office in Stamford.
The coaches and PC staff certainly have input, but ultimately, he'll decide when the time's right to bring the GMs from NXT, Raw, and SmackDown here so you can showcase your talents.
I'm ready for that now.
Yeah, we know you think that, but it's not your call, Big Shot.
Okay, now that all that's out of the way, we're gonna start with some one-on-one matches to see where everyone's at.
All right, new guy, since it's your first day, we'll let you choose who you want to face.
Okay, let's get started.
before you say anything, do you really think you just got everything I had? It's obvious I shouldn't be here. So I'm not gonna give 100% in a training match against a nobody.
Cool. Is that what you're gonna tell Triple H? Because he'd probably want an explanation for why the hottest free agent signing since AJ Styles just lost to a nobody.
Triple H wasn't watching our match. The coaches just say that to scare you rookies.
You think so? Because I'm pretty sure after I beat you, I looked up at the camera and saw it zooming in on me. Probably Triple H wondering who this rookie was who just showed him they're wasting a crap ton of money on an overhyped bust.
Face me when it really counts, and we'll see what happens.
Here's the thing. I think it already did, and we saw what happened. But I'm happy to give Triple H a replay anytime.
Hey, big news. We got another member of DX coming to help out for a bit at the PC.
Hornswoggle?
No. One of the members of the best version of DX, X-Pac.
No offense, but I actually think the original version of DX was the best.
Wow. Offense taken. It's funny, Sean almost tells me the same thing.
You guys were cool, but Sean and Hunter were the OGs.
Okay, what if when X-Pac is here, we had a match to settle this debate? You and your OG hero, Shawn Michaels, versus me and X-Pac.
I've got two words for you. I'm in.
Leave that to the pros. Tengo una gran oportunidad para ti. That's Spanish for I got a big opportunity for you.
Ignoring your terrible Spanish for a second, what's the opportunity?
WWE was contacted to send a PC student to El Mago's retirement show in Mexico. They actually requested Hector, but for some reason he doesn't want to do it. So if you're interested, we'll have a triple threat between you, Paragon, and Chase to decide who will go to face El Mago's son, El Mago Jr., at the event.
Reservar mi vuelo, which means book my flight.
I only looked up that one sentence, so I'll take your word for it.
Yeah!
Good luck against El Mago Jr. in Mexico. I hope you beat him.
That's the plan. I've been meaning to ask, why didn't you want to go?
Yeah, just wasn't feeling it.
It would have been a chance for you to compete in your home country. And you're probably a fan of El Mago, right?
I was, but he wasn't a fan of me. That's all I can really say. Just go get the win over Mago Jr.
Okay.
I was in a bit of a philosophical mood last night, and I started to wonder. If you never have a chance to use your finishing move, is it still a finisher? Or is it just a regular old move?
What are you getting at?
I guess I was thinking about how dominating my finisher is going to be in the WWE, but you guys are probably never even going to get to use yours, which is kind of sad. Total waste of some perfectly good finishing moves.
I'd like the chance to prove you wrong.
Really? Okay, well, how about we have a little fatal four-way finisher match? First one to hit theirs wins.
I'm not gonna waste my time proving some daydream of yours wrong. I know my finisher is legit, and soon everyone else will too.
I was in a bit of...
What are you getting at?
I guess I was thinking about how dominating my finisher is going to be in the WWE, but you guys are probably never even going to get to use yours. Which is kind of sad. Total waste of some...
I don't think you have to worry about that, since I guarantee I could hit my finisher on you today.
Really?
Deal. I look forward to showing you that my finishing move is not gonna go to waste.